Well, my next guest is president of the Ruth Institute and a passionate defender of families and Bible-based moral values. Her new book is called The Sexual State: How Elite Ideologies Are Destroying Lives and How the Church Was Right All Along. Please welcome Dr. Jennifer Roback Morris. Dr. Morris, great to have you here. Thank you. I consider it pretty bold that somebody is out there saying that the biblical mores of sexuality, that marriage is important, family is important, gender is important, it seems like that ought to be fine, but that's a really dangerous stand to take these days.
The truth is, the church has been right all along, and Jesus knew what he was talking about. Imagine that. The Son of God knew what he was talking about.
I mean, I know I believe that. Tell me, when you say the church was right all along, what was it right about?
Well, first of all, when Jesus tried to warn us off about divorce and remarriage, he totally knew that this was going to be a train wreck, right? That divorcing for any reason or no reason, which is basically where we are with no-fault divorce, and then being able to remarry legally, right? Because that gives you the right to legally remarry. He knew what that was going to do to children. Mm. He knew how that was going to be so disruptive to the life of children, how the loyalties inside the family would be conflicted and difficult. And despite what they show on TV, step families have a lot of issues that they have to deal with. It's very normal for children to want their own parents, for children to want their mother and father to love each other. And when mom and dad say, you know, honey, we still love you, but we don't love each other anymore, the kids can see through that, right? Because your other parent is half of who you are, right? And so when your mom and dad say that to you, it's like, gee, this doesn't quite make sense. And yet you're telling the child that there's something wrong with them. You'll get over it, honey. We'll take you for therapy. You know, that's basically the position of society. Well, Jesus knew that wasn't going to work.
But the argument is, but if we're happy, why should it be anybody else's concern? And I'm hearing this on Christian campuses.
The idea that all you have to do is be happy, that's a very weak basis for keeping a marriage alive. That's the line of thought that got us where we are today with the 50% divorce rate, right? That's what brought us to where we are today.
The whole idea of transgenderism, now some people are alleging there are 57 or even 100 different genders. I mean, it's unbelievably confusing. There is clearly something called gender dysphoria where people are maybe confused. But why shouldn't we accommodate all these people so that if they want to identify something other than their biological self, where does that lead us?
Transgenderism is the assertion that there is no sex of the body, really, and that you can remake yourself however you want. And I think what's behind that is a kind of resentment of the body, right? That we're limited by being a woman or by being a man, and so therefore we can just switch it out if we feel like it, you know?
Well, Dr. Morris, your book is called The Sexual State, and one of the things that I found really stunning, and I've never heard anyone else really discuss this, is that the state is largely, the government, largely behind some of these transformations.
Yes.
So explain what the sexual state is and means, and how did we get there?
Yes, by the sexual state, what I mean is that what we call the sexual revolution was orchestrated by elites who captured the power of the state. Hmm. So Margaret Sanger, whom you were speaking about earlier, Margaret Sanger was not content just to go around chatting with people about why they should use birth control. She had a whole legislative plan that included abortion and contraception, but it also included mandatory sterilization. That was part of her plan too. So that's just one example. Removing the permanence from marriage, that was done by the state. Redefining gender so that there are not just male and female, that's being done by the state. And it's like there's some groundswell of popular opinion demanding any of these things. None of it. It's all coming from the top down. And that's what we've got to stop talking about religious liberty, if I may say so. It's not just that we want the right to have our crazy beliefs. No, our beliefs are correct and we can prove it.
That is stunningly powerful, and nobody is saying it like that. Thank you for doing so. I'm so grateful to have you on the show, Dr. Morris, and I want to just make sure that everyone gets a copy of your book, The Sexual State. It is a powerful read. And get one for yourself, then get one for your pastor, and one for your local government officials. All right, Keith Bilbrey is going to let us know just how we can get that book. Keith?
I would be happy to. Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse's book, The Sexual State is available now at Amazon and at other top booksellers. Also, follow her Facebook page, The Ruth Institute.